Traditional phones in hospitals are becoming a relic of the past.
Right now, we have conference calling with an external provider that we're spending quite a lot of money on. So once we get this fully installed, we're going to eliminate that and save some big dollars there too.
Next on Health Tech Today, we hear from a hospital that's looking to save time and money with the latest in connectivity. Timely information is critical in healthcare, and traditional phone systems are becoming outmoded. Today, there's a need for the phone to work with IM, email, web, and video conferencing. But changing hospital infrastructure is a complex and often political process. When is the right time to do it? And do the benefits outweigh the growing pains? Baycrest of Ontario, Canada is just beginning to make that transition. And joining us today is Baycrest eHealth Director Terry Tucker to offer insights about making that change. Terry, it's wonderful for you to come all the way down from Toronto to join us here on Health Tech Today. I came across the Baycrest story a while back, saw what you're doing with Link 2010 and Exchange, and I said, I've got to have these people on our show because they get it. They're already seeing amazing value. It's healthcare is all about communication, collaboration. So tell me the story.
Well, the story started when we realized that our current voicemail system was at end of life. The support was stopping for it, and we need to make an investment in some kind of a solution for that. So we looked at different solutions, and everything involved at least a six-figure investment, and it was a little bit painful. And infrastructure in hospitals is a little hard to get money for sometimes. So we had also seen some demos with Microsoft Link and Unified Communication, and it seemed like it was a perfect match for us. So we called our Microsoft guy and said, let's talk about this, and it all happened. It happened easily, and it's happening smoothly, and it's really exciting. And the staff are really excited about it, too, you know, as opposed to a voicemail upgrade that doesn't sound too sexy.
And, you know, with gas now at an exorbitant price and all of us looking at ways to cut down on transportation, this has a real appeal for mobile and home workers as well.
Exactly. So we've got a couple of different opportunities. So some of our staff are already working from home using this. A lot of our staff have like an hour-long commute from Toronto, and so they'll be using this kind of technology to have their voicemail sent directly to their cell phones and, you know, start the productivity before they've even come into the office.
It's not only about saving time, but more importantly, perhaps saving money. Tell me about that.
Well, there's a few things. So first of all, we saved money with the voicemail upgrade. And then secondly, right now we have conference calling with an external provider that we're spending quite a lot of money on. So once we get this fully installed, we're going to eliminate that and save some big dollars there too.
And again, it's not just about replacing the phone. It's IM, it's messaging, it's email,
right.
It's video conferencing, it's all kinds of opportunities. Can you give me an example of how clinicians are reacting to this new tool?
We have residents in-house, and when a patient deteriorates and they need some support from the clinician on call in his home, we're going to actually use this technology for an instantaneous connection between the resident and the physician to do an assessment both on the patient, but also so that the physician can assess how stressed out the resident is and how much support he needs.
And recalling those days also well, myself, I can imagine how reassuring that can be both for the attending physician and the resident to make that video connection so they can see and hear each other and talk and discuss what's going on with the patient.
Exactly. It seems like it's a win-win situation for everybody.
Well, I really applaud the work you're doing at Baycrest. You're a forerunner. It's very innovative. I'm seeing probably more uptake of Link and Unified Communications around the world in health than anything else right now. And I just think it's so on the money and it's what's needed in healthcare. So congratulations on the good work you're doing up there.
Thank you. This is the fun stuff.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us. Thank you for joining us. We always enjoy hearing your feedback, so please send me a message on my health blog. And we'll see you next time for another episode of Health Tech Today.
For more thoughts, comments, news, and reflections on healthcare IT, join Dr. Bill Krantz on Health Blog.